we do. So we in the building, just Jay. I've been doing, I don't know, I was talking about Jay's talking shit. That's a show I called myself doing today. So that's what we on right now. And I met this guy out at an event. He was popping. He was exciting. It was a lot of stuff going on. I said, you know what? Come on through here so we can rock it on this interview. So tell the people who you are and where you from.
Hey, how's it going, guys? First and foremost, I want to thank Hype Magazine for having me. So I appreciate it. My name is Caddy Exclusive. I'm originally from Fort Worth, Texas, which is right outside of Dallas. But I've been in California the last couple of years, and now I'm out here just trying to test the vibrations of this universe, and just doing whatever I can to express that through my spiritual gifts with this music. So I definitely appreciate that.
Okay. So what record are you currently pushing? Because I know in the club you had your single.
My single is called Damaged Goods. Damaged Goods is it's a feel good song. It's funny because ironically, one of my front homies, he had told me that the song made him apologize to his girl and go get by her Christian Dior back. So that's something that y'all gotta go see. It's trending on Apple Music too. As well, Caddy Exclusive, Damaged Goods, and the song is just basically about just normal life and stuff that we go through. A lot of guys don't know how to really express themselves, and one of my spiritual gifts is communication. So that's one of the things that I do in my music, is to communicate messages. And all it is saying, hey, basically, you know what, I'm damaged. Like, I'm not trying to hurt you by doing this stuff. It's just that because these other people did this to me, this is just how I am right now, and I'm trying to relate to you. So it's a really good song. It's something that people should hear, and definitely appreciate that.
Okay, dope. So being in this music industry, you just moved to Atlanta. You know, what's the culture like? Is there a culture shift? What is it?
I'm gonna give my personal opinion. And it's gonna be very blunt, because I'm very blunt and honest, and I don't care. You know what I'm saying? I feel like Atlanta is very, very, it's a homey atmosphere, but there's a lot of runaways. There's a lot of people that come here, that literally try to do more than what they really have to.
Right.
And a lot of the things I was taught, my dad passed away 8 years ago, and one thing that he taught me was that relationships build everything. And I feel like that a lot of people come here because they know that it's opportunities of a lifetime, it's people that really do stuff. But I feel like that they don't carry themselves in a way that would get a person seen now.
Right.
And coming from California, being in the military, being around a lot of the atmospheres in different countries and also different states, I just feel like that Atlanta's one of those places that is like, it's whatever you can make it.
Yeah, it is.
It's whatever you can make it. It's a land for creators. Mm-hmm. So if you ain't creative, you're gonna be eliminated from the playing field. Yeah. I just like to be in the mindset of a creator so I can always, you know, keep progress going.
So do you classify, which type of artist would you classify yourself as being at this point?
Well, as an artist, I feel like it's whatever the beat is, because I got a classical background. I was R region in high school. Came from gospel stuff. My dad was a jazz musician, so I feel like that I call my music ghetto gospel.
Okay.
So it's really like it's bringing the soul back, but it really has a real messages behind it. So I do that. Plus hip hop, pop, because I got a publishing deal that's on the table. So I got songs that I'm writing for Cardi B, songs that I'm writing for Light Skin Keisha, songs that I'm writing for Chris Brown. So it's like these are producers from majors that are sending me their beats. So I just feel like I tap into everybody's realm, because I feel like that if you can tell somebody's story. And just because somebody can't speak it, you know, that's an amazing feeling.
Right, definitely. Definitely. What is the track that would define you? What's one of the tracks you've done that really explains who you are?
It's a song that I haven't even released it yet. It's called PTSD. Because I did 8 years in the military. I was in the Navy.
And I've been overseas. Everybody, whether you're a kid or adult, or have always dealt with something that was post-traumatic, something that was out of the norm that you've seen or went through, whether it was a funeral, or whether it was somebody that died, whether it was anything. And that song right there builds manifestation. And me, if I can't help other people manifest with my music to give them either inspiration or to teach them how to do it, then I feel like then that's putting me less than what I said in the beginning of the interview, is that I'm a creator.
Right.
So I just feel like that track and one of the tracks that's already released, which is really, really big, it's called Mermaid. Mermaid is just one of the things. It's about love and unity and vibrations. And that's how Caddy Exclusive really is. Anybody that ever meets me for the first time, they're always gonna see like that positive aura that comes around it. And a person that is really genuine, that really like loves people. And Mermaid gives that melodic feel. It gives that feel good feel, and it's old, but it's new. And it hits everything, and it's an undeniable record, which is like how me, I feel like that I've done enough in this society. I've done enough in serving our country. And I've done a lot as far as getting myself in the position in music. That right there, it speaks so much for it, because it's a unicorn love.
Right, definitely, definitely, definitely. So what is your, do you have a social media outlet that you use, preferably like Instagram,
yes, ma'am.
Twitter?
Yes, ma'am. IG is my number one and thing that I do. Instagram is KDDY Exclusive, when you see it with the two red bags, because I always keep me a designer bag. Everybody knows that. And this is real designer, this is not, not fake. I always keep things authentic, you know what I mean? Because it's too many fake and flagrant people out here.
Right.
You know
right,
what I mean? So I always feel that the more authentic that you are, is the more that people were going to take you serious. If
right,
not,
right.
I wouldn't be next to her.
Hey.
You feel me? If I wasn't authentic, because she only interviews the best. So I appreciate it. It's like dreams coming true, and it's like almost put me in tears thinking about it, because like my father's birthday was on September the 30th, and one of my producers, his name is Nick Fury, he's did stuff with Grand Hustle, with T.I.,
right.
with Rick Ross, and it's like this is, it makes everything worth it. It
yeah.
feels like that his death came is not in vain. It comes like, it's like, okay, son, now I'm really moving with you because you're moving with God.
Okay, all right, I heard that. Well, y'all heard it first here. I'm with the Hype Magazine. We're going to be catching up with him later on, too, probably in the dance party on the 28th,
for
to
sure.
get a more in-depth interview. He came through to the We Mix. We just ended up chopping it, so I'm just happy to have him out.
For
sure. You know what it is, the Hype Magazine.